In this week's Marketers Report, we hear about the importance of local radio from Allison Griffin, head of marketing at State Farm.
iHeart has such a broad broadcast reach that is local, and for us to be able to touch customers with a local feel but at a national scale is so efficient and important for us.
As the number one audio company, iHeartMedia gives marketers access to the audiences, trusted influencers, and data you need to grow. If you're a marketer, go to iHeartResults.com.
So, I just got the State Farm Personal Price Plan on my car insurance.
So you told your agent you play the bagpipes for your dog?
What? No, I didn't get that personal. My agent just helped me create an affordable price just for me. Okay, let me show you what I've been working on. Hey, Buster!
Call State Farm agent Denton Acheson in Lake Stevens today.
Prices vary by state. Options selected by customer. Availability and eligibility may vary.
You don't know me.
A confession I can't take back.
I am
the Masked Speaker.
When I was a kid, the naughtiest thing I ever did was go out with my friends dressed in all pink. Whoa. And we'd cover random people's front lawns with dozens of plastic pink flamingos.
Oh, man.
Whoa.
Got him.
Yeah. That's so cute and also kind of expensive, Jeffrey.
Sorry, did you say badass and cool?
Oh,
thank you.
Yeah,
that's how, the legend of the pink flamingo banditos came to be. True story.
You just got flocked.
And lately, we've been getting lots of mass speaker requests from people who want to confess things that they did in their childhood. So let's do that and start with a guy who wants to go by Alex today. Alex, welcome to the show.
Hey, thanks for having me, guys.
Hey.
Okay, would you consider yourself a good kid or a bad kid overall?
Or a flamingo bandito growing up.
Ooh, I was never as evil as a flamingo bandito.
That's true.
Okay,
no one can
all right.
Be.
I was always a good kid, always a good kid.
Okay.
We'll see about that. Voice changer is on. You're the mass speaker. Whenever you're ready, let's hear your confession.
One night when I was about 10 years old, my friends convinced me to sneak out of the house.
Ooh. That's pretty young to be doing that.
Yeah, a little young. But the whole idea was that we were going to go to the local school and egg it.
So it was probably like 8:45 p.m. too?
Yeah.
But I was a very, very good kid. And I didn't really want to do it. I was just trying to fit in, with my buddies. I would have gotten away with it, but poor little innocent old me was so worried because I was left with the two empty egg cartons and I couldn't find a recycling.
Oh, you're going to recycle them. I like that.
Wow.
Yeah. We can't throw them in the garbage.
They say compostables. Yeah. I just need a recycle.
That was the main thing on my mind is, let's recycle.
Yeah, right.
So what'd you do?
Well, while I was walking home, I had the egg cartons in my hand, looking for my recycling bin, and sure enough, a cop comes pulling up.
That's so scary when you're that young, even.
Yeah, and there I am caught red-handed, or I guess yoke-handed.
Oh, God.
Yeah, you quickly figured out that I was the one, so of course, being 10 years old, I started crying.
Man.
Did you blame it on your friends?
No, they took off running, so I didn't want to bring them down. I'm too good of a kid.
What did the cops do? Did they put you in handcuffs?
No cuffs. That would have been terrifying. But no, they put me in the back seat. So I'm like, oh, no, either I'm going to jail or I don't know. Like, how long do I get for eggs? he dropped me off and gave me the threat of I'm going to come back tomorrow. I'm going to talk to your parents.
Oh, no.
Wait, he didn't knock on the door just then? That's crazy.
No, he just let me up there.
You probably had better stuff to do.
Yeah.
But he never showed up. He never came back the next day, so I was sweating for months just thinking that this cop's going to come.
Oh, that's smart of the cop. Every night, and you were on the best behavior of your life, I bet,
right.
After that.
That's actually worse than him showing up the next day and just getting it over with.
The now
you're living with the guilt.
The impending doom,
Oh, my gosh.
Of your dark crime.
So your parents never found out?
No, parents never found out, so nobody knows until now.
Well, we got to get to another caller. We have someone who wants to go by Tiffany today, too. Tiffany, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Hey.
All right.
Yeah.
How you feeling?
I'm good. How are you guys?
She's excited.
Very perky for someone who's about to share a dark secret from your childhood. But voice changer is on. You are the mass speaker whenever you're ready. Let's hear it.
Well, it's not dark, but I don't come off really great. So I have a younger sister. We're 5 years apart, and okay. She was always very gullible. Mm. And I always loved to mess with her.
When she was six, she was really prime.
Yeah, you know? That's what older siblings do.
Yeah.
So we can call her Carrie. So one day I joked and I was like, Carrie, you know, now that you're 7 years old, it's time that you knew our big family secret.
Oh boy.
What is she? Is she adopted?
Yeah, it's normally
your
it.
Your dad's an alien?
No, it's so dumb when I think about it now. But I said, you know, Mom, she isn't really our mom. Our real mom got eaten by a lion.
Oh my God.
In Africa on a safari.
You told this to a 7-year-old?
Yes. And then I told her that an agency sent over this, like, replacement lady, and that's our fake mom.
Whoa.
And then I said, the good news is, she's just a fake mom, so you don't really have to listen to her.
Oh, God.
Oh, no.
You're just setting her up to get in all sorts of trouble.
But that is sound logic. Like, yeah, that right. Worked on any kid.
Meanwhile, this fake mom, that is your real mom, right?
Yeah, Jeff.
Oh,
of course,
God.
Jeff.
Are you going to believe it, too?
I was kind of buying into the lion-eating story, too, for a second.
So what really happened on the safari?
Very convincing. Maybe it's the voice changer that got me.
I'll never forget how she looked. And she was like, oh, my God. And all she wanted to know really was, did our dad know? And I said, yes, he knows.
Does our dad know?
He was there.
Yeah. When you're seven. Yeah. So funny.
And then she spent the whole day just ignoring fake mom's requests. And our mom was kind of exasperated, like, oh, my God, she's getting so stubborn. And my sister, yeah, she's always been stubborn, but she was just like, nope, not going to do it.
Yeah. Get out of here with your fake requests, fake mother.
Go back to the agency.
And then at the end of the day, our dad got home, and I had told her to, like, don't bring it up because it's, you know, it's kind of painful. But she went straight to my dad, and she was asking about what did real mom look like and what was it like when she got eaten by the lions. And he had to show her a picture of our mom holding her as a baby, you know, just to really convince her that she was really our mom. And yeah, I was grounded for a month, and I don't usually tell people because I come off really mean.
I don't know. I'm an older sibling. I don't think it's that mean. Is that is that bad?
I think it comes to the territory.
I want to know if I can try it on my brothers now.
Yeah. Text in 78592. If you have a confession you've been holding on to, we can hide your identity, mask your voice, and make you the next mass speaker.
Ooh.
Phone tap's coming up next.
Brooke and Jeffrey in the morning.
In this week's Marketers Report, Raja Rajamannar, Chief Marketing and Communications Officer of MasterCard, talks about measurement.
Measuring Sonic and Sonic branding and Sonic initiatives across the board, the principles of measurement are the same, but the parameters that you measure are different. We measured, and what we find is our investment is paying for itself in oodles. We have been partnering with iHeart across multiple platforms, both for brand enhancement as well as for performance marketing. I think the cut-through of the message and the recall of the brand are much higher. Also, that has been very beneficial for us to integrate some of our campaigns into the native content of iHeart. It has been a very nice partnership, and it continues to be very strong into the future.
As the number one audio company, iHeartMedia gives marketers access to the audiences, trusted influencers, and data you need to grow. If you're a marketer, go to iHeartResults.com.